Hi, welcome to another Derek Burleson Art. I promised you guys last time that we were going to do a simple little pencil drawing. And today, that pencil drawing is, I've got kind of my reference here. We may change it up a little bit. But we'll be focused down here, and this is something I think everyone can do. You can kind of take your pencil, paper. Doesn't have to be anything fancy as far as pencils. I've got three here that I'm going to use. Just so if I break any or I don't have to stop and keep going. But it's they're just basically little sketch pencils. Nothing fancy. Just a number two if that's what you have. But anyway, we're going to get started. And I hope you enjoy this episode of our pencil drawing, and I think everybody can do it and will enjoy it. All right, I think we're about ready to get started. Got my, like I said, my charcoal pencil. I've got a ruler. How much of the ruler we'll use, I don't know. What we're going to do is we're going to kind of find where our horizon line is, and really don't need to do a lot with it yet because I don't know. I'm just going to kind of put it here. Don't have to, just a very light line. I don't know that you can see that, but it's just a very light line that we're going to use here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start out with some mountains. And we went through the mountains, remember on our last video where we went through the mountains and did them with a dry erase. Today we're going to do it with a pencil, and we have a little bit more leeway with this where we can do some shading and things like that. So again, I'm going to start out with just that same basic little, remember how I'm kind of bring that down, remember that kind of check mark we talked about? Let's just kind of use that, and we're just going to kind of go up that way, back down. Remember, we don't want real straight, and then we're going to kind of draw that line like that. There we go. And then remember we came over here. Shade that in. And again, I'm going to go kind of quick because I want you guys to be able to just to set and do this in one setting. Show a little bit more detail, but also allow you guys that you can really get into it and put all that you want or all that you can in there. And remember, our light's going to come from this way, so we're going to shade it. You do not have to bring your light from that side. I do it, I guess, because I'm left-handed and it just feels better. And remember how we kind of came down through here, but we're not taking it all the way down. I'm leaving some voids in there. Not taking it all the way down. And then you can kind of take your finger there, that way. Gonna kind of come down through here, make some crevices. I think we got a little shadow right in here. Well, we're gonna kind of bring this around. There we go, kind of like that. And then you kind of can kind of highlight this a little bit. But we're just bringing in some shadow where you think the shadow would go, and kind of how the rock formations. It's completely up to you how you want to do it. We can even start to shade this side, but a little lighter, just a little light pressure. But your pencil has so many different shades of color in there just by the amount of pressure you put on it, just by tilting your pencil a little bit, it gives you so much more. And again, we can come in here and we can start to darken in areas if we want. And just remember, I don't want that to be, it kind of got straight on me there. And mountains, they don't have a lot of straight lines, so kind of do that. Something in there. Maybe I'll just do that with my finger. There we go. And I think that's a pretty good start to a mountain. And let's come over here. And you don't have to do it the same. When we paint, we do the same thing when we paint. We'll put our base coat on, and then we'll start going back in. And then we can put on our highlights. We'll move my board there too much for you. What I'm using here is I have a plein air stand that I could take outside with me. I actually have paints down here that I can take with me and go outside and paint. It's a lot of fun. All right, well, let's just kind of get this shaded in. Again, I'm going to move quickly just for the purposes of the video. But I want you guys to just take your time, put it in how you want it. There we go. Just ever how you want it. You can put some more shadow in there. Just whatever you feel like. You know, again, this is your painting. We're just kind of so I can put some on this side, even though it's in the shadow. I can put more in here and just kind of make it just look like you can see rock crevices. And again, this is just, we're moving fairly quick. You can do so much more and just make it look just absolutely real. Okay, I like that. Now, remember how in our last video we showed that little up and down kind of heartbeat thing? Well, we're going to do that here and just bring it up just kind of to a point. Kind of find where we want to start. It's just random. But it's going to kind of give the illusion that there's some trees way in the background. And if you notice, this is starting out the exact same way as our other one. So you're probably thinking, wow, we're doing the kind of the same picture. And we are in a sense, but we're going to add more things to it. I'm just going to kind of seat this a little bit, put a little shadow under my trees and just kind of put it back there. See, just kind of spin that around. I'm going to make that kind of look like mist over my trees and a little mist there. And I'm going to leave that open because I'm going to put my barn in there. All right, now we got this. I like that. We can always come back later and we can highlight it, darken it, do whatever we want, but right now I like that. All right, now we're going to use a little perspective to get our barn like we want it, but we're not going to go right into the 1 point or 2 point perspective where we have our where our vanishing points are, because sometimes your vanishing point may be here. It may be way out or way out that way somewhere that you use. I've seen where you take and tape a board or paper way out there and you put your vanishing point way out. Kind of depends on what you want. for this, I think I'm just going to kind of put my vanishing point right up here in the corner. So I want the height of my barn, and you don't have to use a ruler. We can just use it. Let's just use our hand here. We'll just kind of freehand it, and I'm going kind of straight across, and I'm going to kind of make this barn roof kind of go up and down. I don't want it to be real straight. Now from there, see, you've got your perspective, so we can kind of go wherever we want. I don't like that because of my barn, so I'm going to bring my vanishing point over to another area. So since I'm up higher, as you can see, I'm going to bring my vanishing point down in here somewhere. So as long as I have the same vanishing point, I like that a lot better. And then from there, same thing. And we're just going to kind of, then I want to bring this roof down. It's kind of like a gambrel type roof, if you've heard of that. And I'm bringing that, and I want that to kind of go there, something like that. And we'll get all this in. And then I'm going to kind of come down, so if I had my same vanishing point, something like this. Like that right there. And then come down here. And again, I'm just doing a quick sketch because I may want to move things around. Bring my barn there. Bring it down here. And again, I'm going to kind of use a vanishing point over here somewhere. Again, we're not really getting into a whole lot of where our vanishing point is. Again, this way, just because I want to move a little quicker on this. But I want to kind of give you how you kind of get these angles and where your angles, where they go off to. So I kind of like that. Remember our trees back there? Well, they're about gone. And what I can do is always keep me a little eraser, you know, like a gum eraser. And because I move things around a lot. But if you've got an eraser on the end of your pencil, that's okay. And we may put some trees back there. All right, I kind of like that. I do like that. Anyway, I'm gonna say that we've got a hole in our roof. So let's just kind of take that in my time, or I'm going really fast. So you can come in here and just watch this and then go, okay, I know what he's kind of doing, or what he's doing, so I can take my time and just really blend and really make this start. Now we know it's a little darker on this side of the, so I can make this more in shadow, and then kind of got our this darken that down there, but all right, I think that's probably pretty good. You know what? Let's put a fence going along there. So what I want to do is I want to get kind of my perspective of a fence post, about how tall it would be to a barn. Now, we're going to use kind of that same perspective. I want it to run along here. So a little trick if you're doing like fences, is you can kind of put you a line. Now, normally if I was drawing this, this would be kind of an imaginary line for me, but, or I would make it imaginary, but you can't really see that one. So then you could come up to the next one, find your spacing, straight up and down, but go from the bottom of that line to that line. Come to the next one, line to line, bring your distance in just a little more, then the next one, line to line, bringing that distance in, line to line, 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 and kind of make your, see how they're coming in together, and then you kind of just fade them off that way. So there is your kind of fence. I put a couple little strands of like barbed wire, but now you can kind of come in and knock that top line out if you want. There you go. And then we'll just smooth it back in. Now we got a little shadow, so I'm going to just do this. This is going to kind of be the shadow line. There you go. Now we have shadow on our fence posts. All right. Now, remember in the last video we did, we put some cattails in or some weeds, so you can actually do that right here. And kind of boom, just boom, and then up, and then make them look like they're falling over into the water. You know, they had a storm, water rose a little bit. And then just, again, kind of the same concept as your fence, but we're making them kind of go smaller as they go back. And then we can just kind of do that, and this will be kind of our... And then you can fix that up here. But again, we're just giving you some ideas here. I'm not going to go crazy. You can put as many of these as you want in there. And then, so anyway, you got kind of some, maybe the water is running really, or it's not even running at all today. It's just really smooth. So see, I'm gonna, like they're reflecting into the water. Just little reflections into the water. There we go. And let's put, you know, like I said, I'm not gonna mess with a lot of these. There we go. I think that's good enough for what we're doing. All right, now let's put some trees in, and I'm going to change this up just a little bit, and I'm going to do the trees the same as I did the fence. So let's say I want my first tree right here, and I'm going to make it just about that height. Again, we're going to find wherever our vanishing point that we wanted to go from. In this instance, we'll just say here to here. Now let's put a tree over here, but you can come outside of that line, but we want to use the upper line. So it's kind of going down, so we don't have huge trees way in the back, and then our trees in the front are smaller. So anyway, remember how we did it in the last one? I'm just going to quickly go through these because this is really easy. Basically, you're just putting some lines, just little zigzag lines. We're just, if they're up really close, of course, we want them to be more detailed. But way back there, they're not. They're just the indication that they're trees, and you know that they're kind of, and I can widen my, you know, they're kind of some kind of pine tree, or, and now from here, remember we had our, and then kind of into the water. There we go. There's our first one. And again, we can make this wider if you want. Here's our next one. And again, I'm just going to go really, really fast on these trees. You, like I said, you take your time and you make a really nice painting if, you know, for you. All But I'm trying to kind of show you the concept of smaller getting bigger. If we want to put another one here. There. And then remember, starting small, as you come in, you're coming down, your leaves or your branches are kind of coming out more. But that'll give you kind of an idea. And then maybe if we put one over here, and this is kind of up closer, so maybe we can make this just a little bit more. Like I said, I'm just throwing these in, but you will you'll just be able to take your time and just go to town. There we go. And you could put more grasses in, do whatever you want. You can just go to town here and just make all of this grass and just keep on going and make it just as elaborate as you want. You can put a waterfall in here like we did on the last one. If you want a tree, if you're getting kind of tired, you want some more trees, but you're tired of trees, put one up here like in an angle. And it kind of goes way off there and then kind of put you some little gnarled limbs. This thing has been dead and it's been struck by lightning or something, and it's about to fall. That's all I know. So, but you could do that. You maybe put you another dead one here, just some, and you know, maybe just kind of dress it up. But you can do anything you want. And again, this is going to be hard to do, but I've never written, I've never signed my name backwards, but there we go. So anyway, I think that we're going to call that done. Like I said, it's just a simple little painting for you to do, but I kind of went off of this. This was kind of my doodle I did, and I showed you that on a previous one, but we kind of just made it a little different. But at the same time, we used it kind of as our reference. And you can see the barn's a little different. We could go in and we could make the barn much more detailed. But again, this was just for you to get an idea of how you can just make a simple little pencil drawing and make it look really good in a matter of maybe 30 minutes. You can take your time and make it as elaborate as you want. So, we will get back to doing some paintings, actual paintings, but I wanted to take a couple, do some pencil drawing, do chalk, do dry erase, whatever, just to show you how easy it is to draw. I hope you all had a good time, and I hope you can take a little time to yourself and do this. I think you'll enjoy it. Anyway, thank you for joining me again. I look forward to our next painting project. Until then, bye.